So I'm so glad to have you with us.
Thanks.
Last month, you launched a project to provide a paid writing opportunity for local writers in the District of Columbia. I'm sorry I missed out on that, but tell me about it.
So we've been trying to do something for a very long time, which is to use our platform to give more Black people the ability to tell their own story. And this is something that has been near and dear to us for a very long time. You know, we're booksellers and we love, you know, getting people access to stories, but we wanna make sure that even if you're not a published writer, even if you're not on their radar, that you do have a chance to tell your story. So we applied for a grant through LISC to help provide five local writers, mostly from the Ward 8 area, to pay them throughout the year to write content for blackbooksmatter.com, which is our website, that talks about this last year and all that they went through, the good and the bad, and to tell their story of how they've made it through the pandemic, the social unrest, the election, and just talk about how it's impacted them.
That is, that's amazing. And what a wonderful, wonderful project. I can't mm-hmm. wait until that year is over. And if we can join you as we talk to those writers and what they produced, are they, and I don't want to stay too stuck on this for too long, but you know, what range are they? Men, women, younger, millennials? What are we looking
Everyone.
At?
Everyone. We want a wide diversity of voices, men, women, young, old, inexperienced writers. We just want people to be able to tell their story, whether it's through fiction, nonfiction, however it is. We want to hear from people so that they have a chance to express to the country what it is that they're feeling, specifically from this area, from Ward 8 Southeast.
Have you selected those people already, or?
We are working on it. So
I'm
partnering with Panama Jackson, one of the founders of VerySmartBrothers.com, to help curate and edit all of the content. So we're going through the last bit of essays that was submitted to us to make our final selections so that we can get an introductory piece out this month and introduce all the writers and start getting things out on a regular basis. Hopefully every 2 weeks is the goal, to have pieces posted onto blackbooksmatter.com for people to read and talk about.
Well, please make sure we know who those five writers are that are lucky enough to get selected so that we can feature them in Informer. And of course, you know, they will be among the class of writer that, or individuals like the one who came to visit you recently, who is prolific, whose book is right over your right shoulder, and that is former President Barack Obama. Tell us about his recent pop-in on your book discussion.
Wow. So incredible. You know, it was a long time dream of ours, something we've talked about before we had a chance to open up our Anacostia location here, to just dream about having a chance to host President Barack Obama for a author talk or a book discussion. So when the opportunity was put out too, was that he wanted to join our Mahogany Books Very Smart Brothers book club for a discussion with our members. I mean, we were just super excited. We were told, you know, we held it as a secret. We told people that we would have someone from the Obama administration join us. We didn't tell them who it was. So when we had the discussion of a promised land, and he popped in, and people's like jaws just kind of dropped, was like, is that really him? It's like, yeah. So it was exciting. People were super ecstatic for it. And they asked, it was a really, really good conversation. And exposed what people were feeling and what they were thinking of about where we are today in this country.
What is, that would have been thrilling to me as well. I mean, just to be on a conversation thinking it's just going to be, you know, us and then someone who's uninvited, but, you know, you would love to have invited, mm-hmm. thinking they were going to tell you no, and then they show up, right? Mm-hmm. So I know that was quite a thrill. And I want you to tell us a little bit more about the Very Smart Brothers Book Club.
Mm-hmm. So it's the Mahogany Books, Very Smart Brothers Book Club. So again, Panama, who is a good friend of the store, a good friend of ours, he's a frequent, he's a big reader. He lives here in Southeast. We partnered with him to have a, hold a monthly, we do a monthly book club where we read a variety of books, new books, old books, best-selling books, classic literature. And we meet here at the Anacostia store the first Friday of every month prior to the pandemic to discuss these books. So we've had numerous conversations. We've read things from Zora Neale Hurston to, bell hooks, all about love. And we've had these conversations monthly, and they've been lively, engaging. And the relationship with myself and Panama leading those discussions is, it's all about a lively debate. So we invite various viewpoints. We don't, bash anyone for having those viewpoints, and we just want to share and learn from each other.
That's fantastic. And, we people in Washington, particularly those who live east of the river in Ward 8, were so thrilled when Mahogany came to the community, and that you've been able to really serve a community, and people are coming from all over now mm-hmm. to the bookstore, except now we're getting ready to have a little bit of competition. And our Prince George's County editor, Will Ford, weighed in because we're excited to hear the news that you're opening up a new location at National Harbor. And congratulations. I mean, there's nothing like seeing bookstores growing as opposed to them closing. But what was so important about going to the National Harbor?
So, I mean, it was fantastic. And let me just say, Anacostia has no competition. Both of these locations are in places that are near and dear to me. I lived here growing up as a young child in Southeast. So this is my home. My grandmother lived here. My family, we would have celebrations here. So this is my home. But I also grew up in Prince George's County as an older kid. So to be able to put a bookstore there as well, in a place that is, again, majority Black, without a maybe one or two bookstores inside the Beltway, is super important for us to, again, continue the mission of making books accessible, to bring authors to our community, to allow for conversation, discussion, debate, and to spread ideas. So it's just really important that we continue to make these books accessible. And we have, a place where community can gather and just enjoy ourselves, enjoy each other.
And so this is Black History Month. Congratulations. Well, let me ask you this. When do you open?
So the goal is to open on Juneteenth. Will be our grand opening, 2021, June this year, this summer.
Okay, fantastic. So what books are rolling off your bookshelf for Black History Month this month?
Well, there are quite a bit. The number one book that we're seeing right now is Ibram Kendi's new book, 400 Souls. That book just released, I want to say last week, and it's been pretty difficult to keep on our shelf. The other book that people are really, really into, and it's unfortunate with the untimely passing of Miss Cicely Tyson, but her brand new book that just released as well, Just As I Am, is a constant mover, and we're just getting boxes in every week to keep up with demand. So those are two books I think that everyone should read. Number one, Miss Tyson is an icon. So you're reading history when you read about her life, all the great things that she's accomplished. And to read a historian like Ibram Kendi, who just really opens up, makes history very accessible and get into the details of things that we really didn't learn as kids, is another place, great place to start.
Well, I'll be down to pick, and I say down because I'm up the hill, but I'll be down the hill maybe this weekend to pick up my copy, see what you got there. And I need to get another copy of Barack Obama's book. I bought it and I left it in a bag when I went to a friend's house to give her a birthday gift. I mm-hmm. left a bag, and she told me later on, "Oh, thank you for the book."
Oh, so that was a gift. All right.
So it ended up being, the other gift. So I bought three or four, like Dr. Sherman. I bought several already, so I have to bring another copy. buy another copy, but also I'll get what you all recommend. I am so, so happy and excited for Mahogany Books. Tell your wife, your co-partner, your co-superhero, whatever Tracy called you, your co-superhero.
Right.
Congratulations. We want to see so many more things happening. And that means you're growing because people want to know more. And that's what that means. And I'm just appreciative that you all are here to serve our community.
Well, we thank you. That's what we're here for, to serve our community.
All righty. You all take care. And I'll see you hopefully this weekend.